That is why, comrades, in this situation, the main task that emerges is that in today's situation, this RSS-BJP government has to be defeated, and this can be done only by mounting popular protests and struggles on the basis of alternative policies. When the election come, our draft political resolution says very clearly that this task of defeating the RSS-BJP will have to be done without entering into any understanding with the Congress or having an electoral alliance with them. But at the time of elections, appropriate electoral tactics will be worked out, whereby the maximum pooling of anti-BJP vote will be done in order to achieve this objective of defeating this BJP and the communal forces. But the final point that needs to be understood is that these forces cannot be defeated through only elections alone. That's important, very important. But they'll have to be defeated through the basis of strengthening the popular struggles for alternative policies, and that is the basis of building these struggles and the unity of the left and democratic forces in order to achieve this objective. And that is the basic struggle that will have to be done to organizationally, politically defeat the agenda of the BJP RSS, without which this Republic of India and our transformation of this Republic of India and our People's Democratic Revolution, through which we'll go towards socialism, would not be possible. So that is the task. And Kerala unit of the CPIM, has always played an important role in contributing to strengthening of the basic task before the communist movement and before the people of India all over the country. And the next 3 days, I'm sure with this glorious legacy that the communist movement in Kerala has, with the actual strength and inspiration that our martyrs themselves and our struggles give us to meet the new challenges of our time, the next 3 days the Kerala party will discuss all the concrete issues required not only to strengthen the party in Kerala, the LDF government in Kerala, but to strengthen the unity of the left and democratic forces in India, and to mount this all India offensive against this communal forces and their agenda for our country, and to advance our movement for a radical revolutionary change in our country. That will be discussed in the next 3 days. With that confidence,